Okay, man, back to you. That was a little too loud, the music. Oh, here we go again. Okay, that's not quite as loud. Okay. Okay. You want to make some comments, sir? It's going to be nationwide on YouTube.
Yes,
is that
I'd
all
like
right?
to.
Is this the kind of change you can believe in?
This is the kind of change to be afraid of, Nancy. And this is grassroots, Nancy. So God
bless you.
Are you
talking about Nancy Pelosi?
I'm talking about our dear Nancy Pelosi. We're not mean. We're not angry. We're not hateful. We just want our own individual freedom. Name me one program that the United States government has taken over that has been a financial success. We're so confused we don't know the difference between taking care of someone who needs immediate health care and the whole insurance thing, which is something that you earn. That kind of health care that we have is because we have jobs and we work for them. If people can't afford health care, it's up to us to give individually on a grassroots level. It's not up to us to allow the government to put a gun to our head. Freedom is the root of all morality.
Okay, what about Barack Obama's contention that he's just providing a public option to compete with the greedy insurance companies?
I think that if he deems this as greed with the insurance companies, then he needs to allow the existing laws to take care of whatever problems there are. More laws means more confusion, and we already have enough confusion. Our problem in this country is not a financial problem. It's a moral problem, and our financial debacle is rooted in that moral problem. And that moral problem is a loss of the sense of sacrifice. It's always unconscionable to put a gun to people's head through taxation and everything else and say, you must give 35 or 45 or 50% of your income in order to help a program which is not an efficient program. And that's what socialized medicine is. Every country that's had socialized medicine has had nothing but horror stories. It'll always involve rationing, and it'll always involve people doing distribution curves to ascertain who gets to live and who gets to die, instead of the family members making individual financial sacrifices to determine who lives and who dies and how much care. I mean, what you'll end up seeing is even restrictions of palliative care. So people that are older in this country that are looking at this topic and wondering whether or not they're going to get something for nothing, there is no such thing as something for nothing. There's only redistribution of wealth. And, you know, you can't be a socialist and an American at the same time. It's just it's impossible.
So Joe the Plumber got it right when he was concerned about the redistribution of wealth that Obama was proposing.
Absolutely, absolutely. Listen, I have no personal animus against any of these people. I just do believe that they're not very well educated in terms of the history of our nation and the history of what it means to earn your own keep and for you to have the freedom. They talk about the poor and this whole idea of giving money to the government so the government can redistribute it, but the government can never redistribute as effectively as things can happen on the grassroots level. I mean, there are people in my own life that I help on a personal level. Nobody knows about it. It's between me and God. Not even they know. The point I'm trying to make is that when you put government into that equation, you take the choice out of it. And when you take the choice out of any moral act, it is no longer a moral act. There was a young man, a young Polish man, who graduated from high school many, many decades ago, and he said at his speech, he was the valedictorian of his class, he said, "Freedom is the root of all morality." And that young man's name was Karol Wojtyła, and he later on became John Paul II. So freedom is the root of all morality.
Very good, sir. Would you like to give your name?
Sure, my name is Bob Fox, F-O-X.
And what town are you from?
I'll just say I live on Long Island.
Okay, very good, sir. Appreciate your comments. Thank you very much.
Have a great day.
You too. With answers how best to make this happen. It's a new day. How you doing, sir? You look pretty hot out here. looks like you're sacrificing for something.
Sacrificing for freedom and to do away with this Obamacare that's only going to take away our freedoms and kill a lot of people through eugenics.
So Barack Obama's not really providing the change you can believe in?
Barack Obama, I never believed he was the change you could believe in. He's proven to be true to me, to my beliefs. He's not changed. He said he was going to take the troops out of Afghanistan. He hasn't done that. He said he wasn't going to have anything but no lobbyists in his administration. He has nothing but lobbyists in his administration. Obama is definitely not the change that you can believe in.
You've marched for green power and woke up the planet. You've marched to...
Oh, ma'am, you're out here on a day that's over 90 degrees. What brings you out here?
These are some very dedicated people today to be out here in this heat.
Right, well, what brings you out here?
I'm here for the healthcare debate. I feel very strongly that the government should not control our healthcare.
Okay, so Barack Obama's not providing the change you can believe in?
No, not even close. It's okay. A change. It's definitely a change, but it's not what we were hoping
so
for.
So change can go either way, for the good or for the bad,
right?
Okay, so... what do you think, what message do you want Congress to get about all these protesters?
I would like them to really start listening and looking and seeing it for what it is. We're not backed by any huge groups. We're not special interests. We're just interested Americans who want to know exactly what's in that bill and exactly what it will lead to in the future.
Right
now it seems like there's no true definites that they can make some plans later on once it's passed. So that concerns me.
Well, you seem pretty soft-spoken. You don't sound like one of the angry mobsters that they're talking about. So.
Well, I'm more concerned than angry. I don't like what they're doing, but I'm more concerned than angry.
So do you take offense when somebody like Harry Reid calls you an evil monger?
Very much. Definitely not.
That's heavy, heavy talk coming from the speaker, excuse me, not the speaker, well, she's another one, but the Senate Majority Leader. I think that's like, never in history, a Senate Majority Leader put down the American people to that degree.
No, that's very offensive.
Pretty shocking.
I'm just a mom, and I'm out here concerned for my family and everyone else's family.
Right. Appreciate your comments.
Thank you
so much. All right. Hands off healthcare. Don't you believe Barack Obama when he says he's just trying to help everybody?
Short answer, no.
Short answer, no. Okay, so he's not providing the change you can believe in, I guess.
No, I don't believe in the change.
Right.
He can keep the change, actually.
He can keep the change. Okay, so you think Barack Obama is being disingenuous when he says he's really only for a public option, when this video showing him clearly stating that he was for the single-payer plan. So what do you believe he's really for?
Well, you just answered my question. I've seen both sides, and he has to be lying in either instance.
Right. So so basically, he's kind of spinning his way through this bill.
Well, he's not the only one. So are most of the Congress people, the senators. They're spinning it also. They're lying. You know, they're lying.